وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلي وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أنه محمدا عبده ورسوله. ما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. First of all, جزاكم الله خير brothers in ICK for arranging this webinar, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept this from you and from us. As you see, my topic is about one of the major sins, which is zina, wal'ayadu billah, zina. And in this lecture, inshallah, I would like to focus not on the danger of zina, but the warning of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He says, وَلَا تَقْرَبُوا الزِّنَا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَا تَقْرَبُوا. What does it mean, وَلَا تَقْرَبُوا? Don't approach. So it is important, brothers and sisters, to know the disease and how to protect ourselves from this disease. For example, now everyone knows about the diabetes, and for example, hypertension. We know that right now, Corona, COVID-19, and of course, everyone now likes to know how to avoid COVID-19. Keep distance, wash your hands. The mask has a percentage, 10%, 50%. So everyone likes to know, even now the kids, many of them, they wash their hands, they use the sanitizer. So it is very important to protect yourself. How can I protect myself? I should seek knowledge. I should know the things lead to zina. And of course, it is very important to know the things that lead to zina, to avoid them, because zina is one of the major sins. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, وَلَا تَقْرَبُوا الزِّنَا. Don't approach adultery. إِنَّهُ كَانَ فَاحِشَةً وَسَاءَ سَبِيلًا. Verily, it is a fahisha. The word, yeah, subhanAllah, yani, when you read this word or when you hear this word, إِنَّهُ كَانَ فَاحِشَةً. Okay, it is not only a sin, no, it is not only ithm, but fahisha, you feel, subhanAllah, you feel the danger of this sin, fahisha, something huge, something fahusha in Arabic language. When I say this is fahish, fahush, it means it is big and danger and yani something like that. Also, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked by Abdullah Mas'ud, Ya Rasulullah, ayyu dhanbi a'zam? What is the greatest sin? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned the first thing, shirk. An taj'ala lillahi niddan wa huwa khalaqak. An taj'ala lillahi niddan wa huwa khalaqak. Okay? That you set up a rival unto Allah, though He alone created you. This is the first or the most dangerous. Number two, Abdullah Mas'ud asked, then what? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, to kill your son lest he should share your food with you. Killing your son because you fear that he will take some of your food. You don't want to be poor. This is the next after shirk. Then the third, to commit illegal sexual intercourse with the wife of your neighbor. Yes, in this part, I mean the third one, the danger of zina, and also to do it with your neighbor. It will be worse. It doesn't mean that to do it with someone I don't know, not my neighbor, is okay. No, it is haram, but it will be worse if it is with my neighbor. Okay, so, and there are other ayat and hadith about the danger of zina. As I said, I will not talk about the danger of zina, but now how to protect us from the zina, from the word, وَلَا تَقْرَبُوا الزِّنَا. Because in this ayah, the scholars say, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not say, don't do zina. It means don't approach. It means don't do the things that lead to zina. Don't do the things that lead to zina. Let's take the ayat and the hadith which help us. Help us. I'm saying help us because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves his slaves. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves the Muslims to protect them. How to protect them? He told us how to protect us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ يَغُضُّوا مِنْ أَبْصَارِهِمْ قُلْ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ يَغُضُّوا وَزْمِ يَغُضَّ يَغُضُّ I am walking like this in the street. I see something. Suddenly, then, immediately, I lower my gaze. يَغُضُّوا مِنْ أَبْصَارِهِمْ قُلْ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ يَغُضُّوا مِنْ أَبْصَارِهِمْ وَيَحْفَظُوا فُرُوجَهُمْ Tell the believing men to lower their gaze from looking at the forbidden things and protect their private parts. It means from illegal sexual acts. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, that is purer for them. Verily Allah is all aware of what they do. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants the Muslims to be pure, clean, sound. How? Lower your gaze. This is maybe the main thing that can lead to zina, to adultery, if you don't lower your gaze. Especially nowadays, brothers, sisters. Subhanallah. Maybe now, I'm watching, I'm reading from the mobile, okay? Immediately something comes. Advertisement. About many things. About business, and sometimes, subhanallah, about something haram. Women, they send you, pictures. And now, for example, now I'm alone at home. I'm alone at home. Or even I'm not alone at home. But who can see my mobile now? My wife, my brother, my sister, my son, my maid, they cannot see. It is only for myself. And sometimes they put something on the screen. I remember in the shops of the mobiles, they tell you, put this. Then your colleague and the one who is sitting next to you cannot see your screen. Subhanallah. Subhanallah. This to keep your privacy. Yes, sometimes you put your password, you have some private pictures with your family. But subhanallah, also the bad people use it in the haram way. So it is very important, brothers and sisters, to lower your gaze. Be careful. The mobile with you now. You are alone with the screen. And now, subhanAllah, everything is open. Okay, now it is very cheap maybe. You can buy 500 GB or maybe 1 tera GB. You pay maybe 10 KD monthly. And you can watch 24 hours the movies and the haram things. Who knows that you are watching the haram? Maybe you are with us in the masjid for the Fajr prayer. For the Asr prayer. Maybe you are with us in the da'wah, but subhanAllah, the shaytan comes to you. إِذَا خَلَوْ مِحَارِمِ اللَّهِ انْتَهَكُوهَا Don't be one of this group, subhanAllah. When they are alone, they do the haram. But when they are with people, mashallah, they are scholars, they are sheikh, they are da'iyah, telling you haram, wajib. Subhanallah, subhanallah, one person was complaining about his friend, saying, subhanallah, he's doing the haram alone, but with others, stop the music, do this, don't do that, subhanallah. Are you cheating Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Of course, you have to tell people to do the wajib and to avoid the haram, we have to do that. But also we have to apply the sunnah on ourselves before the others. So lower your gaze. طيب. And sometimes maybe people say, okay, subhanAllah, I'm working. I'm busy with my laptop. I'm doing my job. And if this comes to my screen, Okay. Number one, we'll tell you, brothers, please, brothers, sisters, if you can, stop these videos or these advertising pictures, stop them. Sometimes you need to pay. How much? Maybe it is 1 dinar a month or 2 dinar. Pay. What is the problem, brothers, sisters? Yani, subhanAllah, some of the Muslims, if there is any application, you need to pay, for example, $2 or $3, they will avoid. They want everything free. Do you want to enter paradise free? You have to pay. Okay, you have to pay to protect your vision. You have to protect yourself. So please, brothers, sisters, if you can stop these things, you have to stop them. Even if you need to pay, pay. 1 dinar, 2 dinar, 10 dinar, what is the problem? Pay to protect your religion. You are paying to protect your health. Pay to protect your religion. Okay, if something, even if you pay, this comes to your screen, or maybe in the street. As the Prophet ﷺ mentioned, that the first time, you are not guilty. I'm walking the street, I'm driving my car, then you saw something, a woman without hijab. Not intentionally. Allah will not consider this as a sin. But if you keep looking at that woman, then this is haram. Al-ula lak, wa-thani alayk. The first time is for you. Why? Because I cannot walk in the street with closing eyes. But the second time, for example, you notice that the one who's driving the car next to you is a woman without hijab. So now, no need to look at the woman second time, third time. Wallah, you want to check. Okay? Oh, this is haram. Allah knows. Allah knows, subhanahu wa ta'ala, everything. What is your intention? Okay, so this is the first thing, that lowering the gaze. قُلْ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ يَغُضُّوا مِنْ أَبْصَارِهِمْ. Another thing, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said in the hadith, a man must not look at a man's private parts, nor must a woman look at a woman's private parts. Neither should two men lie naked under one cover, nor should two women lie naked under the same cover. SubhanAllah. So this is to protect the community. It is not allowed, even the man with the man. Okay, in this hadith, the Prophet ﷺ mentioned the man with the man. So it means it will be more dangerous and worse if it is a man with a woman. You got the point, brothers and sisters? In this hadith, the Prophet ﷺ said, the man, it is not allowed for him to look at the awra, the private part of the other man. So can we understand from this hadith? Okay, so the Prophet ﷺ said, it is not allowed for me to look at the man, but it's allowed to look at the woman. No. It means it is more dangerous and worse to look at the woman. Okay, so please, brothers, sisters, be careful, because sometimes, subhanAllah, maybe the boys in the school, when they have the PE class, when they play sport, or when they go to the swimming pool, this is also common, subhanAllah, among the Muslims. Yes, we are men together, boys together, but this doesn't mean that I look at your awra and you look at my awra, my private part and your private part, or something above the knee. We have to be careful, brothers, sisters. We need to be careful to protect ourselves. Also, there is something worse than zina. The man with the man, the woman with the woman. I mean, amal qawm lut, homosexual. Wal-iyadu billah. Okay, so one of the things that to protect us and to apply the ayah, wala taqrabu zina, don't look at the awrah. And also in the same hadith, neither should two men lie naked under one cover. Okay, maybe most of us cannot imagine that, but to make it closer to our brain to imagine, maybe this happens with our children. Khalas, your son, your daughter reach to the age 10, you have to separate them. As the Prophet ﷺ said, وَفَرِّقُوا بَيْنَهُمْ الْمَضَاجِعِ. Tell your children to pray when they are 7. years old. And when they are 10 years old and they are not praying, you can beat them. And then the Prophet said, وَفَرِّقُوا بَيْنَهُمْ بِالْمَضَاجِعِ. And you need to separate them when they in their beds. Okay? يعني, this call is mentioned, yeah, for example, if you have a house, alhamdulillah, you have good space. So the boy in one room, the girl in another room. Wallah, you say, well, I don't have a space. I don't have space. I have only one room. Okay, you keep one room and the boy in one bed and the girl in another bed. Yeah, and you should do your best to avoid any contact, direct contact between your children. This is very important. Also, one of the things comes under the ayah, وَلَا تَقْرَبُوا الزِّنَا. The Prophet ﷺ said, and no one of you should be alone with a woman. And no one of you should be alone with a woman. I'm sure many people will say now, Subhanallah. Oh Sheikh, what you are saying? We are at work. What is the problem? I am a doctor. I am a nurse. She's a physician. She's a radiologist. She's a doctor. She's a member in the parliament. We are doing our job. What you are saying, Sheikh? Not I'm not saying anything. This is from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I mean, this is not from me. Listen to the hadith, please, brothers, sisters. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said again, "La yakhluwanna ahadukum bimra'ah." And no one of you should be alone with a woman. Why? He said, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said, for the shaytan will be the third one present. Because if you are alone with a woman, of course it means not mahram. It doesn't mean that your wife, it doesn't mean your mother, your daughter, your... No. The hadith means who is not mahram. She is... maybe she is a patient, or she is a doctor, or she is with me at work. It is not allowed to stay in one room. Khalwat. What is the meaning of khalwa? You are in a closed room. You are in a closed room. Like the clinic. When the door is closed, the windows, the curtains are closed, so no one can see you from the people. This is haram. She's a doctor. Yes, even if she's a doctor. SubhanAllah, this is common. Also here in Kuwait, wallahi. We should, please, brothers, sisters, it doesn't mean that they are evil people, but sometimes, subhanAllah, they don't know. They don't realize that. Okay, why? Because they are busy, so we can't tell them, doctor, maybe my son, my husband, my wife can join me. For example, if there is a male nurse, should be with the male doctor. You should do something. You should recommend them. You should advise them. Okay. Also, it is not allowed for the doctor to stay with the female nurse. The male doctor with the female nurse, or the opposite. It's not allowed. And wallah subhanAllah, they sit together, they chat together, they love to. Maybe sometimes we are waiting outside and we notice that they are chatting together. Subhanallah. So also, this is one of the things that we should avoid, to be alone. Even the scholars mentioned that even in the lift, sometimes you are in a building and you want to go up or down. And when you want to enter, there is one lady. Or for the sisters, there is one man. Avoid that, okay? Yeah, and do your best. Do your best, please, brothers and sisters. There is another hadith, the same. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, no one of you should meet a woman in a privacy unless she is accompanied with a mahram. Okay? Your mahram should be with you. Your brother, your sister, okay, or another woman. It means man and woman together alone, and they are not mahram, it's not allowed. It's not allowed. Why? Because, subhanAllah, this can lead, why? The shaitan is there, can lead to zina. The shaitan is there. Also, one of the things that comes under, don't approach zina. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he took the pledge of allegiance from the woman by words after reciting the ayah in Surah Al-Mumtahina. Okay, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, the hand of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam did not touch the hand of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam did not touch any woman's hand. Okay, yani when the Muslims, I mean when the men accept Islam, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam was shaking hands with them. Okay, accepting Islam, and this is a pledge between the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam and the Muslims. But he did not touch the hand of any woman, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, of course, except for someone, yani, like a wife, a slave. This is okay. But as a woman who is not mahram, he did not touch. And also, this is, subhanAllah, very important, brothers and sisters, touching the woman. This is very dangerous. I mean, the direct contact. That's why the scholars very serious about the hospital. The man should treat the man. The woman should treat the woman. It is not allowed. I mean, as a general concept. I'm not talking, please, brothers, sisters, I'm not talking about the exceptions, because when I mention this point, immediately some people say, Sheikh, but there is no specialist. I'm not talking about the exceptions. The main concept, it is not allowed for the woman to visit a male doctor. She goes to the hospital and she chooses a male doctor, or she has the option and she doesn't take the female option. Okay, it's not allowed. Why? Because there will be direct contact. The doctor wants to touch the abdomen, the shoulder, the leg. Okay, we have to avoid that. The Prophet ﷺ did not touch a woman who is not allowed, who's not mahram for him. So, yani, if there is, yani, about the hospital, I know, because many people ask, if there is a need, yani, for example, what, as I know here in Kuwait, we don't have, or I did not, yani, for myself, I'm working at the hospital, I did not see any woman who works with, who are specialized, I mean as a doctor, in orthopedic, to treat the bone problems, the joints, all of them men, as I saw them. Okay, so in this case, what she can do, خلاص, she goes there, but she has to take her precautions. يعني she goes with the mahram, with the father, with the brother, with the husband, okay, and يعني if he wants to examine, يعني she should expose only the needed part. She should be very careful. Okay, you should not say, wallah, he's a doctor and he will not think about haram. No, you don't know. He's a human being. He's not an angel. This doctor is a human being. You don't know. Yes, not all the time he's thinking about haram, but you don't know what will happen. Yani, subhanAllah, I think I mentioned this hadith maybe last week, about the point that the doctor will not think about the haram. I am a doctor. Okay, I remember one of the sisters, and she mentioned this to me, in a maternity hospital. Alhamdulillah, she's niqabi. She was covering the face. And subhanAllah, yani, her delivery was not normal. And you know, in maternity hospital, yani, difficult to control. Wallah, you want a man, a woman, you know, sometimes immediately, especially if it is urgent. So a male doctor came, and she was with niqab. He did not examine, he wants to ask. So the doctor was upset. Why you are covering your face? I am a doctor. So what, if you are a doctor, but still you are a man and I am a woman and you are not mahram, and this is haram in Islam. Inside the labor room, I am a Muslim. And also you are Muslim. Islam is with us everywhere, brothers, sisters. Islam should be with you any place. In the masjid, at home, the toilet, the hospital, you should be a Muslim everywhere, all the time. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu udkhulu fi as-silmi kaffa. You have to accept Islam, all Islam. Okay, so subhanAllah, this doctor became angry, yani, why she is covering the face? I am a doctor. So what if you are a doctor? A doctor doesn't mean that you don't follow the rules of Islam. Even the doctors should follow the rules of Islam. Also, one of the things very important. Yes, I was going to mention a hadith that about the point that I'm not thinking about zina. It is not in my mind. I'm doing my work. So there is a hadith in Sunan Abi Dawud. I mentioned this hadith maybe last week. That there was a man at the time of the companions, radiallahu ta'ala anhum. He was sick, very sick. Okay, he was on bed and the people were visiting him. It means he was very sick. Subhanallah, he saw a girl or he saw a woman. Maybe she was a maid. Subhanallah, he saw a woman. When he saw this woman, subhanallah, the shaitan came to him and he did adultery with this woman. Can you imagine, brothers and sisters? He is a companion, radiallahu ta'ala an. And he was very sick. But subhanallah. Subhanallah, yani, the shaitan came to him in this point, a weakness point of iman. And he did adultery with this lady. Subhanallah. So, brothers and sisters, don't trust yourself. Always ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the protection to keep you away. Yani, please, brothers and sisters, when I'm speaking about the zina, please don't consider yourself as an angel. No, no, this topic is not for me. I will not do this. Ya Rab, of course, I have to ask, brother, sister, may Allah protect all of us from zina, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect our families from zina. May Allah protect the Muslims from zina. Okay, and also may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect the non-Muslims from zina. This is very bad for the Muslims and non-Muslims. Okay, so please don't consider that, no, zina is not for me. Allahu A'lam, wallahi, we don't know what will happen. Yusuf alayhi salatu wassalam, you know the Prophet Yusuf, Joseph. What, yani, subhanAllah, one of the great prophets alayhi salatu wassalam, the pure prophets, of course, all of them great, all of them pure. He said, وَإِلَّا تَصْرِفْ عَنِّي كَيْدَهُنْ أَصْبُ إِلَيْهِنْ SubhanAllah. You can read this in Surah Yusuf. Yani, you know, at the beginning, the wife of the minister was trying to do zina with him. Then later, the friends of the wife of the minister, also they tried to do zina with him. They were requesting him to do zina. He was, subhanAllah, he was like the moon. He was more beautiful than the moon, alayhi salatu wassalam. Yusuf made a dua. He asked Allah, وَإِلَّا تَصْرِفْ عَنِّي كَيْدَهُمْ. Oh Allah, if you don't keep me away from their plans, maybe I will go with them. SubhanAllah. So, yani imagine, even Yusuf alayhi salatu wassalam was afraid to commit adultery with these ladies. So what about us? May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect our children. Yani, this is very bad. I mean the zina. Also, one of the things Allah says, يَا نِسَاءَ النَّبِيِّ لَسْتُنَّ كَأَحَدٍ مِنَ النِّسَاءِ اتَّقَيْتُنَّ فَلَا تَخْضَعْنَ بِالْقَوْلِ. O wives of the Prophet. Yes, this is for the wives of the Prophets, of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, and also for all the Muslims, the female Muslims. You are not like any other woman. If you keep your duty to Allah, then be not soft in speech. Don't be soft in speech. Why? Allah told us why. Lest he in whose heart is a disease. What does it mean disease? Yani, he has angina? He has stroke? No. A disease of the sins. Okay? Lest he in whose heart is a disease should be moved with desire. But speak in an honorable manner. So many times people ask, is sawt al-mar'a awra? The voice of the woman, is it awra? Is it haram? No, it is not haram. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not tell us that the voice of the woman is haram. It is, he did not say it is not allowed to speak to the man. But what is the problem? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَلَا تَخْضَعْنَ بِالْقَوْلِ. Don't make it soft. It means when you speak, yeah, for example, in the jam'iyya, I mean in the supermarket, okay, or for example at work, or when you go to the doctor, okay, when you call someone, a man, maybe your brother-in-law, the friend of your husband, the friend of your father, okay, when you speak in a normal way. And subhanAllah, maybe for some sisters, for some women, subhanAllah, naturally their voice is, subhanAllah, soft. Yani, let them try to make it not soft, to make it, yani, يعني, let's say, يعني, I will not say to be يعني, rude, استغفر الله العظيم. No, I mean to make it serious. Because you don't know who is on the other side. You don't know the mentality and the heart of that doctor or of that friend of your father or your husband. You don't know. So when you speak in a serious way. Of course, it doesn't mean to shout. It doesn't mean to say bad words. Yani, for example, you are in the market. How much for this? 1 dinar. Okay, can you make it half KD? No, khalas. Yani, don't make it. No, you are a good man. Mashallah, I will tell also my friends to come to your shop. This is not allowed. Please, sisters, this is not allowed to be soft and to make this seller man as a friend and you do marketing for him. You have to avoid that. So this is one of the things that can lead to zina. الخضوع بالقول. Not القول, not only talking, but to be soft. Also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَقَرْنَ فِي بُيُوتِكُنَّ وَلَا تَبَرَّجْنَ تَبَرُّجَ الْجَاهِلِيَّةِ الْأُولَى. And stay in your houses and don't display yourselves like that of the times of ignorance. Again, this ayah doesn't mean it is not allowed for the woman to leave the house. No, it means that يعني, the main thing for the woman to stay home. يعني, for example, the main thing, my wife to stay at home and I work outside. I earn the money. I do the things for the house. I take the responsibilities of the house and to pay the rent, to repair the car. This is my job. Okay, but the woman to act like the man, okay, يعني, going outside like the man, this is wrong. I know. Nowadays, subhanAllah, many women work outside. Some of them need that. No problem if they need. Okay. Even at the time of the companions, at the time of the Prophet ﷺ, some women were working outside, like the hadith Asma, the daughter of Abu Bakr Siddiq, the wife of Zubair ibn al-Awwam. She was working and she was doing something very tough. She was feeding the horse of Zubair radiallahu ta'ala, bringing the food, and even the Prophet ﷺ saw Asma and he was يعني, feeling sorry that she's working and tough thing, and he presented to help her, but she refused. Why? Because she's afraid. Zubair is radiallahu ta'ala an, يعني, was a jealous man toward for his wife Asma radiallahu ta'ala anha. So she was afraid that he will be angry with her. I mean, it is not haram that for the woman to work when she needs and she is with full hijab. But the point is, we don't want the woman to act like the man. Yani, for example, she's chatting with the friend. Assalamu alaikum, how are you? They open the avenue. This is the fourth day in Kuwait. Let's go there for shopping. There is a new shop, there is a new coffee. But there is no table. Yes, we can buy it and we can go to the beach. Yalla, let's go. Nowadays, it is very easy, subhanAllah, for many of them. Many of them, يعني, I don't mean, again, it is haram that you go with your friends, with your... But it should not be like the men. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَيْسَ الدَّكَرُ كَالْأُنْتَ. And also, please, sisters, I'm telling this to the sisters. Okay, يعني, again, please, don't understand that I am accusing the sisters. I am telling that you are bad. If you have a coffee outside or in the restaurant or you go and work, I am mentioning what is in the Quran and Sunnah to protect the community, to protect the society from haram. Because the shaitan, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا خُطُوَاتِ الشَّيْطَانِ. Step by step, don't follow the steps of the shaitan. The first thing is to have a coffee. The second, to have a meeting. The third, subhanahu fourth, until الزِّنَا وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ, the adultery. So the main thing is, please stay home. Yeah, and for example, if this friend call you, let's have a coffee in this restaurant or that coffee, you can tell your friend, please come to my home. I invite you. Or you go to her house, visit your friend. Or she can visit you. Yeah, please try your best to stay home. Try your best to stay home. Why? Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, إِذَا خَرَجَتِ الْمَرْأَةِ اسْتَشْرَفَهَا الشَّيْطَانِ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when the woman leaves the home, when the woman leaves the house, اسْتَشْرَفَهَا الشَّيْطَانِ. What does it mean, اسْتَشْرَفَهَا الشَّيْطَانِ? يعني الشيطان will look at that woman in this way. يعني now, يعني if you see something from far distance and you want to concentrate, usually we do like that, okay? We do like that. Or some scholars, he will touch his eyebrows, okay, to focus. Why? Because this is a very important goal for the shaitan. It is easier for him, the woman, to trap the woman. Also, brothers and sisters, under the ayah, don't approach zina. وَقُلْ لِلْمُؤْمِنَاتِ يَقْضُلْنَ مِنْ أَبْصَارِهِمْ. We mentioned about the man. And here also, the next ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, and tell the believing women to lower their gaze. Ajib. Sheikh, what are you saying? Okay, for the man, it is haram. For my husband, it is haram. For my brother, for my father, to look at the woman. But what is the problem with us? It's okay for the woman to look at the man. No, this is haram. If it is with desire and lust. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَقُلْ لِلْمُؤْمِنَاتِ يَغْضُضْنَ مِنْ أَبْصَارِهِنْ. يعني, generally, is it haram for the woman to look at, يعني, for example, the lecture now, or for example, the khutbah, Jum'ah khutbah, in the haram, in Mecca. Is it allowed for the woman to look at the khutbah? Yes, this is allowed. But when it is haram, it will be haram if the woman watched this video because she's thinking something about this football player, or this sheikh, or this physician. Okay, so at this case, it will be haram, and the woman should be careful. This woman should be careful. يعني, subhanallah, the shaitan, as I say, يعني, the shaitan comes to you step by step. Okay, يعني, listen to this sheikh, or listen to this reciter, or especially, subhanallah, the brothers who are doing the nasheed. The brothers who are doing the nasheed. I'm not talking about the nasheed, is it allowed or not? Islamic nasheed allowed or not? But usually those who, I mean the famous, who are doing the nasheed, the brothers who are doing the nasheed, okay, usually they will not come to the camera, just they put the ghutra and they will put some makeup and they will cut their beard and you notice why you are doing that. Okay, of course, Allah alam about your intention. But this is also a risk for the sisters, especially the girls. Okay, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَقُلْ لِلْمُؤْمِنَاتِ يَغْضُضْنَ مِنْ أَبْصَارِهِنْ. So please, sister, if you have some feeling toward this man, so avoid looking and watching him. I think I should stop now. We have 40 minutes. Jazakumullah khair, brothers and sisters.